What's up, everybody? This is John Barr with Prime Homes coming to you from San Antonio, Texas, and I'm going to present this month's weekly, or sorry, monthly market update for here, what's going on in San Antonio. So we'll go ahead and jump right in. The July number overview, the average sale price jumped to $257,540, which was a 4.68 increase year over year. Median sales prices is at $205,000, which is a 2.5% increase year over year. Total sales, though, did decrease on a year over year status at $2,822. Average rental price, which this kind of shocked me, we've been typically seeing these numbers increase year over year by 4, 5, 6% margins, but this month it actually dropped 3.9%, which is something that's a little interesting to me. Employment was up just over 1.1 million, which is a 1.6% increase year over year, but we did lose 2,648 jobs from the previous month. Unemployment, we did see a pretty nice little spike from the previous month up to 3.89%, which was a 2.8% increase from the previous months of inventory. We did see another increase, so there's more inventory coming on the market, but that is to be expected as far as the seasonal, knowing that our hot months are kind of April, May, June, July, and August. They kind of taper off because school's going into session, not as many people are buying homes, so our months of inventory typically starts to increase this time of year, and that's kind of every real estate market that I've kind of really ever looked at. Now, as far as median sales price on a 7-year average, you can kind of see that we are still on an upward trend. One thing I do kind of look at for the year of 2017 from the previous years, you can kind of see a lot of these look pretty similar as you kind of drop down to December, January, and then climb into the summer, kind of drop down into January up here. It kind of had another spike, a little bit longer spike, then dropped down in January and climbed up. Same thing here. One thing that happened in 2017 is when we dropped off into January, we climbed into February, and then we dropped off in March, and now we have shot up significantly higher in our median sales prices faster than we have any other summertime, and we've also dropped off a lot more sharply than we have any other summertime, where these ones are much more of a kind of up and curve every year except for when we started coming out of the recession, and now we've kind of jumped up and then dropped back down really quickly. So 2017 has not acted like the normal market normally should. So that's something that we're going to continue to watch to see what the median sales prices continue to do in this market. Monthly rents, kind of the same thing, where it wasn't as smooth as an up and downward curve. We kind of shot up, and then we plateaued, and then we dropped off significantly. So that's something to me that's kind of acting a little weird after looking at the data over several years that we're going to kind of continue to watch. 20-year unemployment, you can kind of see the basis like normal. I mean, here was your dot-com bubble, here was your real estate recession, and you can see that we've kind of just been bouncing around here in the bottom for an extended period of time, and we've kind of just had a little bit of spike down here this month, so we're going to kind of continue to watch unemployment, because it's my theory that an unemployment spike and a rise in unemployment, we're eventually going to see that start to trail over into the real estate prices because people aren't buying homes, and I would expect to see value starting to drop if we saw a high spike in unemployment, kind of like we saw here in the Great Recession of 2008. So now where I get a lot of comments people like the most is where to market, where are we seeing the fastest prices rising, where is there chances that they might level off and go down a little bit. And I base that off of the months of inventory. Basically, you can see in San Antonio, as I break this out into 50,000 increments, that we have a bit of a shelf. Here, once we get over 250,000, we really start to get over into the 4, 5, and 6s. Now, balanced real estate market, keep in mind, is considered a 6-month months of inventory between balance between buyer and seller. So anytime you see numbers sub 6 months of inventory, we're getting into a strong seller market, not as much buying opportunity and bargaining power for buyers, just because there's just not a lot of inventory and it's moving fairly quickly. So you can see like the 250,000 range. What I am seeing, though, is numbers starting to rise, and this gap between 250 to 300 starting to close. I'm starting to see numbers get a lot closer in here because typically your 100 to 150 is way down in the twos, low twos, kind of normally where the 150 to 200 range is. I think a lot of inventory is not available as much, and some of the inventory that is available is kind of crappy and people aren't buying it as much. So that inventory is not moving as fast. So now by zip code, this is where month's inventory is the lowest in the city. That is going to show the most upward pressure from an appraisal standpoint to increase prices because there's a very high demand to live in these areas and not a lot of inventory. So you can see how this correlates that every one of these zip codes is below that 200 price range. So this is something for you to kind of take into consideration if you're doing marketing, if you're holding rental property. That is where the fastest appreciation is going to happen, is going to be around in these zip codes, just for the fact that there's just no inventory for buyers. So that's naturally going to kind of push the prices up till it finds its economic balance of supply and demand. Now, your worst zip codes and same thing, all except for one. They are all over pretty much, they're all over $300,000 because that is where, like, if you remember back to here, those 300,000, you start seeing much higher months of inventory in the area. So this is where prices, I mean, the majority of them are still in the balanced market between buyer and sellers, but they do tend to sell a lot longer. So if you're renovating houses in those areas or holding property, that's something to kind of look at is how fast it's going to take to sell and what are prices really doing. Because if you're renovating houses in some of these zip codes, and now it's not saying in the neighborhoods, it's saying just in the zip code in general, that if a buyer is looking for houses in the $300,000-$400,000 price range, they just have a lot of inventory to choose from in the city. It's not saying these are bad zip codes, but it's something to you want to really make sure you are looking at if you're looking into renovating a house. Because this is your holding costs. If you're in a $300,000 house and a hard money loan or even private money loan, if you're paying 12% interest on $350,000, that's a pretty big chunk of money that you're spending, especially if you're holding the property for 5 months once it is on the market. So it's something to take into consideration if you're buying a house and renovating and trying to flip into these price ranges. So with that kind of brings us to the conclusion of this month's market update. If you got, I now I do have the entire list of the majority of or all the zip codes in the San Antonio area. As long as they have over 30 homes sold, I have it, the database, everything in between. So you guys can shoot me an email if you're looking for a specific zip code or the entire list as far as month inventory. I can send it to you as well. And I have my email right here, john@primehomes.com. So I hope you guys enjoyed this information. If you have any questions, comments, or suggestions, please feel free to shoot me an email. Check us out on the web at primehomes.com or go to our Facebook page and like us for constant content and updates. Other than that, good luck and have a great month, and we will see you guys next month.